Hey guys, it's Cooper here, and I'm filming this intro as I'm taking out the garbage because we're in a big rush, but I just wanted to start the intro to this video. And basically, we are driving up to the Seattle area to buy a collection of Nintendo merchandising, promotional, and employee items from an ex-Nintendo employee. So it's going to be very, very cool. We're getting a lot of awesome stuff, and I figured that we'd make a video since it is sort of a special occasion. So I'll see you guys on the road. Let me just show you what we have so far. This is the stuff I've looked up that's worth getting so far. We still have this entire cart of stuff to look up, which Abby's doing now. This is the stuff that's not worth getting so far. So we'll show you guys what we get later. All right, so we just left our first Goodwill, and we did really well at this Goodwill last time we were up here, but I think we did better this time. Got a couple CDs. They're going for $17 and $19. We got a $200 JVC camera. It's missing the battery and the charger, but we can buy those off eBay for like 12, 15 bucks. Found a couple other cameras here that are going for about 60 and 80, and we paid $8 and $10. And then we got a couple really big bags here. Got a Rock Band pedal. We got 5 Microsoft keyboards, which are about $45 each, and we paid like $5 and $6 each. And then probably the biggest score is this factory, it's sealed, still sealed. It's like a book and a DVD kit, but it's listed in books, so we can sell it. We paid $4, and the cheapest new is merchant fulfilled, and it's $150. Cheapest used merchant fulfilled is $200, and there's no FBA sellers, so probably gonna price this at $200. That was awesome. And then the last bag here is a bunch of random stuff. We got a Wacom tablet, we got a bunch of controllers, and some empty jewel cases, a factory sealed Rubik's Cube, a Dremel, a little Franklin spelling ace, and a bunch of other good stuff in here. Nothing too special, but all very good stuff. We got for Superman. That's kind of cool.
Last time we were here, weren't there a bunch of... I think they're only quartz, huh?
Looks like there's some other stuff next time. Boom. Alright, so we just left Value Village, and this is only our second stop. This is our third stop. We stopped at a Cash America, which we didn't film at, but we spent like $300 and something. We found a bunch of video game stuff, and we'll probably show you that once we get to the hotel. But we just left Value Village, and we got a few things. Guitar Hero 2, complete in the box. It's opened, and the game inside is opened, but you can tell the guitar's never been used. The strap is still in the little plastic baggie, and it still has all the stickers unused. That was $15, and I don't think there's much profit on that, but this is in much better condition than the one that I already have in my collection, so it'll at least be an upgrade. And then we got a bag of stuff here. That tech deck thing you saw us pick up, the rank for this is like 20,000 in toys. We're not making much on it, but we're making like 10 bucks profit, I think it was. sealed pack of Memorex CDs here. We paid $3, we'll make about $5 profit. Devil May Cry for the collection. This little Franklin thing, hopefully it works, and we'll make about $30 to $40 profit on that, and there's none listed right now. Clear PSL memory card for the collection. We bought a pink DS Lite in the box for $30, and this is just to keep. And then the score was this Logitech. This is actually a Harmony remote, and it doesn't look like any that I've seen before, but we paid $7, and it's going for like $115, I think it was. And there's none posted. So, awesome stuff here, and now on to the next spot. All right, so we made it to our hotel room. There's the empty Cash America bags, and I've set everything up here just to show you guys what we found. We did end up going to a couple more thrift stores, but we didn't really find anything that wasn't something we had already found earlier. Just a couple more keyboards and a copy of Wii Sports and just some stuff like that. So first, I want to show you the receipt. You can see we spent $328.78 after tax. And this is everything we got here. So a lot of the stuff we're going to keep for our collection, but a lot of the stuff will be sold as well. So first off, we got a Japanese copy of Mario Kart Wii. It's definitely a Japanese copy, and the game inside is still sealed. We got that for $5. We thought it would just be something cool for the collection, and it was only $5, so pretty cheap. Got a 120 gig Xbox hard drive for $5. Got a Wii Motion Plus adapter for $1. And then we got 9 Xbox 360 network adapters. And these are, these two black ones here and all the white ones are about $60 to $70 each on FBA. And we got them for $20 each, and that included one third party one. But I've even sold these ones for $45 or $50. So those should sell for about $630 total. We paid about $180. And I believe it's like $250 profit, that's after fees, on just those. So that was awesome. And then we got a bunch of games here. Some of these will be sold, some of them will be kept. We already have this one. We don't have either of these yet, so we'll be keeping both of those. We have both of these, but we're keeping this one. These three GameCube games were $1 each, which is ridiculous, and I don't think we have this one or this one yet. We definitely have that one though, so just selling this one, that will get like 50 to 60 back because we're going to save it till Christmas and sell it on FBA, so that's awesome. And then we got some Wii U games and some 360 games. Call of Duty Black Ops 2, we already have, not like we're collecting Xbox, but we already have a copy, and I pick this game up all the time to save for Christmas. They go for about 20 to 25 around then. That one was $5. Diablo 3, we just picked up because Abby wanted to play it. Then we got Donkey Kong Country Tropical Freeze and new Super Luigi U, which we didn't have already, so that's awesome. We paid $15 and $20. And then Watch Dogs and Darksiders 2, we also didn't have yet, so we're keeping both of those. I don't remember what we paid. We didn't pay the price that's on there of $13, but it all works out, basically. So, yeah, that's what we got from the Cash America. We only stopped at one, but I definitely wanted to show you guys because it was an awesome pickup. And so we're in the hotel now. We're going to sleep here tonight. And we might do a little bit of thrifting tomorrow, and we're going to be staying one more night. I'm sure we'll be picking up some more stuff, but we're going to try to do some non-thrifting things as well just to have some fun and enjoy our time up in Seattle. So thank you guys for watching tonight, and I'll pick this back up tomorrow. Hey guys, it's the next morning, and we just left the Red Lion. Well, we're still sitting outside, but we're about to leave. We're going to hit up a few game stores today, some more thrift stores, and then we're going to do some other stuff. So I don't think it's sealed though. And that headset's $50. Toys are back there. the electronics person.
Okay.
How to draw Pokemon.
I want it.
It's only 79 cents. My favorite game right here. How much are these?
I want to make one of those clocks. I think it'd be so cool.
There are so many controllers down here.
I didn't have the dog bowl, so I started to cry.
Because they're $46 on eBay, but there's no listing on Amazon. Good thing we sell on eBay, huh?
$4, $35.
$5? Heck yeah. He's plastic. 12. Some video games.
Staying on.
PS1 long box, but we already have that one.
Do you see that down there?
Terminator 2.
That little box thing.
What?
That?
Yeah.
I have no idea what that is. I think it's like a third party MP3 player. So I guess I do have an idea. There's a Rock Band dongle.
Well, I could go back in.
$11. Kind of a weird price. And that is sealed.
Some.
We got this puzzle here. It's like a triple pack, I think. I don't remember what it was going for. We paid $8 though, which is more than we normally pay for stuff like this, so must have been a good seller. We got this thing here, which is also sealed. I don't remember how much this was going for either. There's a lot of stuff. This was $4, it's going for like $25, $30. The rank was kind of high, but oh well. Got another Rock Band pedal. We sell these for about $20 to $25. That was $4. We got two KP310 Panasonic pencil sharpeners for $4 each. We sell these for $35 all the time. Got another $45 keyboard here. We got a black Wii system. Came with the power cable and a sensor barb. Then it came with a GameCube AV cable. And this was $25. There could be a game in it, you never know, but you know, find out when we get home. Plug it in. We got this iPen mouse here, which is basically like a digital stylus, I guess. And this is used and everything, but even used, it has a great rank and it was like $70. We paid $8. We got a couple sealed toys here, probably like double, maybe triple our money on those. We got some turtle paper tablecloths just to keep because it's awesome. This little Winnie the Pooh thing, we paid $1.29, we'll make $10 profit, but it has a high rank. This little light switch here, doubling our money with a good rank. PS1 controller, we sell these for $18 and we paid $4. We got this Belkin cable here for $4 and it's going for like $25, $30 with a really good rank. We got this Sony Dream Machine. It's also an iPod dock. And we've sold one of these before for $95, and we paid $6 for this one. And I double checked, that's still the price for them. We got a silver GameCube here for $13, and we also found the power cable for $5. We sell the power cables for $15 and the GameCubes for about $50, just system only, but we actually need this one to complete a empty box we have for it. Abby got a mirror, that's yours. We got this Sony radio shower. There's no listing for them on Amazon, but one sold on eBay for $95 with the box. There's only one other posted for like $120, so for $4 I took a chance, maybe we'll get like $70 or $80. Got a Wii remote for $5 with no battery cover, but you can order replacement battery covers from Nintendo's website, so I'm gonna do that. They only cost a couple bucks. Got a black nunchuck here, sell those for about $15. We got a few games. These three are to keep. And then we got two Sims 3 expansion packs. They go for about $15 each. And we got this Lexmark Ink double pack here. We paid $6. I don't remember what it was going for, so I'm gonna scan it really quick because I want to remember. It was a good price. So we paid $5.99, and the rank is 12K, and it's $35, so pretty good. But this one here was the home run. This is a pan digital, what do you call these? Digital picture frame, basically. We paid $13. The rank is 246, and the cheapest one is used for $119.99. So that was awesome. I opened it up. Everything inside looks like it has been opened and maybe used once, but everything's in there. Even the original like baggies and stuff for everything is in there. So very awesome. That is the home run of this stop. And that's everything we got here. So on to the next.
Needle. It's also how he had introduced to the world 54 years ago such futuristic inventions as the touch tone telephone that was as big as a shoebox and had an antenna that was half my height. So, man, that was in fact a long time ago.
Wow.
As a matter of fact, the city of Seattle, so long ago, the city of Seattle that you're looking at right now, none of those skyscrapers or buildings were there. The Space Needle was, when it was originally built, was the tallest building west of the Mississippi River for a couple of years, and it was the tallest building in Seattle also for a long time. It's no longer the case in either respect, but it used to be. Now, the observation deck is going to have 360-degree viewing units.
So smart!
Can't really see, but right now, we're at the top of the Space Needle. And so, figured we'd do a little bit of filming up here before the camera dies, because it's about to die right now. Hey everyone, so it's the next morning. We just left our hotel, and we don't really have a set plan. All we know is that we're gonna be home tonight, and we'd like to go to a really nice buffet for dinner this evening. So we're gonna hit up some more thrift stores, maybe some more Cash Americas and stuff, and we'll see.
Over here.
Alright, so we're home from the trip now, and I just wanted to kind of film a little outro to the video to explain why some of the footage is kind of weird and why a lot of stuff was left out. On the trip, it was raining a lot of the time, so showing you guys the stuff that we picked up as we put it into the trunk of the car at most times was just not an option. Just can't have stuff getting super wet like that, and, you know, can't really take our time putting it away, so we kind of had to rush through doing a lot of that stuff. And honestly, there wasn't really much to show in the way of like anything super exciting. A lot of the stuff we picked up that wasn't put on camera was just controllers and a couple calculators and Xbox 360 network adapters and a couple toys and board games and CD players and pretty much just the normal stuff that we always pick up. There wasn't really anything too special, like I said, that wasn't already filmed. So yeah, that's pretty much it. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. I know that, you know, we haven't been putting out much content on this channel, but I would like to start doing that more. No promises, though, because I am focusing on my main channel for the most part at this time. But yeah, thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you guys.